what's up guys. In this video series, I will create a small Lisp interpreter with TypeScript. In this first part, I will introduce Lisp as a programming language and create a small parser for it from scratch. Lisp is a simple but powerful language. It looks like this. It was created by this guy, John McCarthy, when he was younger. Lisp is the grandmother of many modern languages. Racket, Scheme, Closure. There are two main data structures in Lisp, an atom and a list. An atom is either a number or a symbol. A list is a sequence of items, each of which can be an atom or a list. Lisp is an expression-oriented language. Everything in Lisp is an expression. But what is an expression? A statement is like, this mountain is tall. Whereas an expression is something like, when I saw this mountain, I thought it represented my fears and I must climb it. Something results from an expression. Lisp uses prefix notation and it looks like this. First, we go ahead and set up our tools. We will grow the parser with test-driven development. For that, I'm going to install Jest as the testing framework. Now I'm testing out the testing framework. Created two files, one for the code and the other for the tests. And we are ready to go. First thing to do is to split the input into characters. Here, I'm defining the built-in blocks of the language. Union types come in handy here. A union type is where a value can have multiple types. And creating a basic parser for it. Technically, this is called a lexer. I will create a bunch of tests now and make it more robust. Shifting the gears now to parse a list. First, I will define what a list is. Create a test for most basic case. If the input is empty, it should throw an error. A list should begin with an opening bracket. Here, I test for that. Now, a test for an empty list. This is a red herring. This test passes because we are returning an empty list as the default. Let's create a function that could parse the brackets correctly. Loop through the elements and find the opening and closing brackets. When an opening bracket is found, start parsing for a list again recursively. In order to keep track of where we are, we send in the index to the element. Thank you. Now we create a test for an atom in a list. An atom could have multiple characters, so we should track the beginning of what could be an atom. When a space is found, that means we have all the characters for that atom, so we can edit. Another test here, this time for two atoms, one numeric and one symbol. Increasing the complexity with three elements now, newest element being a list. Now a test for an expression that looks like an arithmetic operation. Now a more complex arithmetic operation. like what I create, please subscribe to support the channel. So now we have the code to parse in a string into a well-typed tree structure. In compiler theory, this is called Alexa. In the next video, I will create a parser that can evaluate these trees and apply syntax rules. Join me then.